Good Sunday evening, or Saturday evening, everybody. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek, live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, keeping you updated as to what's going on with the rest of the forecast into the remnants of the holiday weekend. And as of right now, it looks like we've got some fairly quiet conditions out this direction. Don't have any problems in the way of travel into the Mid-South area over the course of the next couple of days. Matter of fact, things are looking pretty good all the way through for the next couple of days. We'll talk more about the forecast as we see it in just a little bit. In the meantime, we see again for tonight, quiet but chilly, and into again the rest of the weekend, pretty dry, but also the possibility of seeing some fairly cool numbers coming up into the next few days. We'll talk more about that coming up here in just a little while. And in the meantime, if you have any questions or anything you would like to know about where it comes to our forecast, please drop them into the comments section. We'd love to know more about what you're seeing around out there for tonight where it comes to weather, and we'll keep you updated as to what's going on when it comes to our forecast here in the next few minutes. As of right now, I would like our Facebook friends join us for this evening. We are live on Twitter, Periscope, and Facebook on my main Facebook page. If you have pictures you'd like to share with us so we could share them on air and on social media, we'd love to know more about them. So please tweet them to me. We'll talk more about where you can do that coming up here in just a little bit. Let's go ahead and get started and show you more about what's going on in the Mid-South area for tonight, which again does not amount to much. It is decently quiet out there and very dry as well. The view from Ole Miss tonight at the Crosby Hall camera looking back toward the Student Union, showing good visibility out there, but not too many people out and about on campus. A few people here and there out for a stroll, but very quiet in Oxford tonight. Downtown Memphis from our Cotton Exchange camera, again showing Big River Crossing lit up quite nicely into the evening hours, and also good visibility downtown Memphis, not seeing a lot of traffic down toward Riverside Drive, so decently quiet there as well. Into and around the area of I-55 and Goodman Road. Again, quiet conditions being seen for the time being, and not too much in the way of precipitation across the Mid-South this morning as that front came on through. And as of tonight, traffic is starting to lighten up a little bit. Still pretty heavy for a Saturday night around I-55 and Goodman Road in South Haven. A lot of shoppers out there, a lot of holidays, family visits and traditions and whatnot going on. So traveling tonight does not seem to be too much of a problem. Likewise, traffic at I-40 and Sycamore View looking good. Traffic back toward the flyover is moving along pretty well. Little wibbly wobbly on the camera. Winds are picking up every once in a while, but not doing too bad across the area for the evening hours for tonight. Getting into the evening hours and toward about tomorrow morning around News Channel 3 daybreak and just afterwards, temperatures should be heading through the mid to upper 50s. It'll be a little bit cooler tomorrow, only in the lower 60s by the time we hit the early part of the afternoon. And thanks to that cold front today, that's mainly what we wound up with, is some of that cooler air. But winds will switch to the south as we get into Monday and Tuesday. So by the time we head back to work or school, temperatures will be getting back to about the mid to upper 60s and coming close to 70 degrees even in the Mid-South over the next several days. We'll talk more about that coming up in just a little while. If you're traveling tonight, maybe catching a red eye, getting back home again, or know somebody who's coming back in town that you have to pick up at the airport, no delays being reported at this time. Clear skies. Green icon indicates delays of 15 minutes or less, so we don't have much going on in the way of problems here in the Mid-South area, so good news on that. What's it look like across the rest of the country? Some of the busiest airports, again, at this time of the year, can get pretty clogged up with human traffic going on through. A lot of people getting back home again or getting a jump start on travel before those clogs start to appear into tomorrow. Looking at good conditions out there for tonight. Now, tomorrow, these icons will probably go, unfortunately, a little bit more towards the yellow or red category as everybody hits the airport and tries to get back home again. So we'll update you on this. If it's a time that we're not on the air with this information, you get more details by going to the Federal Aviation Administration. They have a special website that gets all this information lined up for you, and that's where this comes from. You'd like to get that, all you have to do is go to fly.faa.gov, and you'll be able to find out more about what's going on out there before you hit the airport. But again, travel well and make certain, again, a little bit of extra patience and some extra humanity would not be such a bad idea. Storm Tracker 3S radar, we did have some scattered showers for this morning, but otherwise nothing major taking place at this time. And all the rainfall that we saw from earlier this morning what there was of it is well on down toward the south of us, getting against some light areas of showers down toward Florida, southern Georgia, and that's what's left of that particular system, that cold front, dry air in place throughout the rest of the mid-south area for this evening. And as we get into the rest of the forecast, again, we do not see much of anything in the way of involvement of a large storm system coming on through, so that's good news. Now, we do have a little bit more activity going on out into the Pacific Northwest, so if you're traveling anywhere, say, west of Denver or Salt Lake City, you may run into some slowdowns, especially into around the West Coast states. So SeaTac, Portland, down to around San Francisco, you may run into some delays here at this time as a stream of moisture makes its way on shore. San Francisco may actually pick up some fairly windy conditions. This is what is called an atmospheric river coming in from off the Pacific, dropping a lot of moisture and a lot of cloud cover and some breezy winds out there. Storm system, large one over the Gulf of Alaska, and that is going to help to, again, stir up a lot of the winds and could cause a lot of problems into the area around the West Coast state. So if you are traveling in these areas, something to take a look at. But the rest of the country at this time actually looks pretty good, and that includes right on into the Mid-South, so we see little, if any, problems showing up at this time where it comes to anything involving big delays or slowdown. Lynn Rooks, welcome from Rossville, 54 degrees out that direction. Thank you very much at this time. Kevin Dunn, welcome to the show. Sorry, no spam accepted at this time, but there's plenty of other things to worry about out there where it comes to asteroids. We'll talk about that in future programs. Currently seeing, again, temperatures very much on the mild side, considering it's a little bit chilly, but again, not as cold as it could be for this time of the year. WeatherNet 3, live real-time weather, of which you can access this at your home computer by going to WREG.com/weather if you'd like to know more about what this looks like on your computer system. Again, great opportunity to get more information, not only from the Mid-South stations, but throughout the rest of the world. There's stations like this all over the place. Winds tonight occasionally kicking up to around 5 miles per hour plus, but not seeing much of any problems out there for right now. Getting into overnight, we do again see the potential of winds turning around to the northeast, and so by daybreak tomorrow, numbers back in the mid to upper 30s, so a chilly start to Sunday. Getting through the rest of the day, again, not bad throughout the rest of Sunday. Good travel weather. As we showed you on the SATRAD composite, there's really not that much going on where it comes to storm systems rolling on through. So the delays tomorrow where it comes to weather should be very minimal. Now, it comes to volume of human traffic, that could be another story of people going through the airports out there. It's going to be very busy, but weather looks to be very pleasant, and highs tomorrow only back in the lower 60s. Now, through tomorrow evening, as we get into Monday, winds will start to turn back around from the south, and that means the temperatures will be going back upwards again as we get into very early on Monday. So for tomorrow, a little bit on the cooler side, lower 60s expected and mostly sunny, maybe a little breezy at times again over the next few days, but also warming up as we get into Monday and Tuesday. But then, again, some up and down temperatures coming on through. This right here is very mild for this time of the year, mid to upper 60s. Lower 60s tomorrow, cool, but still above normal, well above normal for the first part of the week. Later part of the week, chances of showers and maybe a few rumbles of thunder, but mainly just showers expected right now through about Wednesday night into Thursday. Then much cooler by Friday and Saturday, but once again, for those of you who think, okay, we're going into December, so we should be getting some bone-chilling cold and some major winter weather coming on through here, not seeing that, that's for certain. Temperatures remain very much on the mild side, close to normal Saturday and Sunday next week. First weekend of December looks cool-ish, but not exactly, again, anything big heading our way. Next best chance of rain after midweek is going to be very far into around the 10-day forecast, mid-60s by about Tuesday, and the possibility of a few showers out there, and really that's going to be about all that we wind up with. Now again, this can change. This is a fairly long ahead forecast, almost a medium range forecast. This again is going to be changing, so this right here, and especially that possibility of rainfall right there, I would take that with a great big grain of salt, just to wait and see what goes on. Keep it tuned to News Channel 3, and we'll keep you updated on the potential of what may be changing here coming up within the course of the next several days. But otherwise, nothing major going on across much of the Mid-South. Thanks to everybody for some great pictures out there. Linda P. Coleman, nice sunrise from last weekend. Nice view from sunrise early today, or early yesterday around Northeast Arkansas by Louie Haskett, and a new guest at Mr. Haskett's house, Betty the Goat. So that showed up around Thanksgiving. Never heard of this before, but Betty making some unique goat selfie appearances. So nice to see the goats doing well at Mr. Haskett's estate. If you've got pictures, this is just a sampling of some of the stuff we get, but we don't have too many of them, so we would love to see your pictures out there. If you don't think you're that much of a photographer, give it a try. Go out, get a shot of the sunset, sunrise. Send them in to us. We'd love to be able to see your work on our newscast and also on our netcast like we do here. So if you want to tweet them to Aonic underscore WREG3, you can also send them to my Facebook page, Austen Onek WREG, and also on Instagram. If you want to email them, you can do that too. That's austen.onek at WREG.com. If you'd like to send those along, we'd love to have your pictures so we can show them to everybody out there. Got some great ones so far, so keep up the good opportunity to see more about that, and go ahead and send those in. Can't watch on TV, can't watch on the computer or on your cell phone, you're around the Mid-South, dial us up on Country 92.5 or Oldies 102.3, my forecast throughout the rest of the weekend there, and I'll also keep you updated as well on social media throughout the rest of the weekend. Shay Arthur will have an update on the news situation on News Channel 3 at 10 coming up in just about a half an hour from now when we record this. Mike Sadie has a very busy day in sports, and of course yours truly. We'll have more details on your complete forecast as well coming up in just a little while at 10 o'clock, and I'll also be back on News Channel 3 Daybreak. Stay tuned for more of News Channel 3 on air and online. Thanks for joining us for tonight's edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime.